Four laps here, qualifying to race number one. And we are green light racing. Ovendoom with an absolute flyer here from P2. Squeezes Howell Ridge onto the grass. There's contact between the two of them. They're going to take a bollard out. Howell Ridge then is going across the field here. He's going to end up being in last position. And Ovendoom then is going to be in P3. And that is, well, the strangest joker I've ever seen being taken, that's for sure. But yeah, that is not ideal. Lost a lot of time and potentially some damage to the car there as well. And well, the big winner of this situation is Steve Hill. Steve Hill leads the way up the hill. He's got Sellett in behind and Ovendoom has got damage to that car after the door banging, after the front banging with indeed Howell Ridge. Looks like Dom Flitney from P5 on the grid on the left-hand side. He indeed has gone down through the joker, so he is done and dusted. Front three, though, are very tightly packed indeed. Steve Hill, though, leading the way. Through that chicane they come. Ovendoom, then, is into the joker, trying to cover off Flitney. Howell Ridge will stay out then. So the front three are indeed going to be Steve Hill, Sellett, and it's going to be Howell Ridge. And it's a terrible joker for Ovendoom, then, just over-rotates the car. Is he going to get Flitney, though? Flitney on the inside line as they come through that sweeping right-hander as we head then back on board with the front two. Hill is actually holding up Sellett here for sure. I'm surprised that Sellett hasn't decided to come into the joker. You can see that Ovendoom then is ahead of Flitney, and it's actually by quite a comfortable margin in the end. It was very, very close on the merge, but ultimately has got that job done. But it's just put those flyer laps in now. The other two drivers, are they going to come in early and try and cover him off, or are they just going to try and do really fast lap times here? I think Hill stays out. He does indeed. And Sellett then into the joker lap. So we've got 1.5 laps to go. Howell Ridge then still in P3, and actually some serious pace because he has closed up to the leaders. And as you can see, he is in P2, but it is a huge margin. There's the merge then between Sellett and the Ovendoom. Ovendoom squeezes Sellett onto the high side. That's the dirty side. It's very tough to get traction through there. And Ovendoom has been in the wars today. He is fought tooth and nail for this P3 as it stands, and ultimately does hold on to that position. How quick can he be though? Steve Hill is probably favourite at this stage of the race to win. He's coming then through Paddock Bend down the bottom end of this circuit and in that final chicane. He will have to indeed take the joker on his final lap here. And will he lead the way? That is the big question here in race number one for Q2, round 7 of the Five Nations British Rallycross. Howell Ridge into the joker as well. And I was saying Ovendoom's joker wasn't the quickest. It actually wasn't too bad considering what we just seen from Steve Hill there. So Steve Hill does come through, but he is in the lead. He has done everything he needed to do, was pole position, and ultimately has gone out there and done the business. Howell Ridge is going to be a little bit disappointed and maybe a little bit angry here indeed with how it went down in towards turn number one with Ovendoom. But ultimately, that is Rallycross. Hill then at the top of the hill as Ovendoom does make a last gasp grab for that P1. We've only got a couple of corners to go, and Ovendoom is absolutely flying here in towards Paddock Bend. We've got the chicane to go. Hill gets through there relatively nicely. Bit of curve on the inside, bit of curve on the outside. Across the line we go, and Steve Hill will take race number one of qualifying number two. In second position then, it will be Ovendoom, Sellett in third, Ridge fourth, and then Flitney in P5.